and we were curious to know why. NBC2's Chandler Blackman is live along the Caloosahatchee, revealing the reason for the remodel.
It's been years since there's been any action at Lofton's Island in downtown Fort Myers. Now people who enjoy the downtown scenery will have something to look forward to soon.
If you've driven along the Caloosahatchee or Edison Bridge, you may have noticed a small island on the water. The rare and exclusive 9.3-acre private island is located in the heart of Fort Myers with easy access to the Gulf of Mexico. It's been undeveloped for years, but after being sold for $783,000, the island is now getting some well-needed attention.
There was a house on it and all that, but, you know, ever since I've been here, it's been nothing but trees.
Today, Captain Mike Burby took us out for an up-close look.
You know, they've got good plans.
From his boat, you can see abandoned equipment from previous attempts to develop the island.
Now you can actually see right through the island. Last week, you couldn't see nothing but trees.
In the last week, trees that covered the island have been cleared. So how soon can you expect to see something out here?
We don't know our final plan exactly. We will certainly renovate the marina slips, and we will certainly do our best to create some type of recreational amenity to downtown.
While there's still some uncertainty, Israel says their goal is to create a beach-type atmosphere right in the heart of downtown Fort Myers.
If you want to go to a beach-type leisure environment, you have to get in your car and drive for an hour. So we're hoping to change that.
And with Legacy Island just a little further north, eyeing an opening at the end of the year, this is something Mayor Anderson says he's looking forward to.
One more opportunity to take advantage of our waterfront. Looking forward to a really great 2021 and an even better 2022.
Now, property owner Steve Israel says they're going to try to get things moving as quickly as they can, saying it could take 6 months to a year for things to finally kick off. In downtown Fort Myers, Chandler Blackman, NBC2.